In this lesson, we're going to look at Lambda versions and aliases. So what are versions? Versioning means you can have multiple versions of your Lambda function. The function version includes the following info: the function code and all its associated dependencies, the Lambda runtime that executes the function, and all the function settings, including the environment variables. It also includes a unique Amazon resource name, the ARN, to identify the specific version of the function. You can use versions to manage the deployment of your Lambda functions. For example, you can publish a new version of a function for beta testing without affecting users of the stable production version. With versions, we work on the $latest. That's the latest version of the code, and it's mutable. That means it's changeable. That's always where we're updating our code. So for example, the function that's called myFunction has a $latest on the end of it here. That indicates the latest version of the function. When you're ready to publish a Lambda function, you then create a version and they are numbered. So we have myFunction :1. That's the first version of our function. The numbered versions are assigned a number starting with 1, and subsequent versions are then incremented by 1. So then we get myFunction2 when we publish a new version of our code. Versions are immutable, so they cannot be edited. That's why you have to create new ones from $latest. Each version has its own ARN, and that allows you to effectively manage them for different environments like production, staging, or development. Now we have qualified and unqualified ARNs. So a qualified ARN has a version suffix. So for in this example, we have our ARN for our Lambda function. On the end, it's got myFunction :2. An unqualified ARN does not have a version suffix, so it just says myFunction on the end here. You cannot create an alias from an unqualified ARN. When you invoke a function using an unqualified ARN, Lambda will implicitly invoke $latest rather than a specific version. Next up, we have aliases. And I'll start off with a diagram here. So we have our Lambda function, and our Lambda function has the $latest where we're doing our editing of our code. So the developer has edited the code and then created a version. And this is the first production deployment, which is saved as version 1. Now, what we've done here is create an alias. The alias is like this. So we've got myFunction :, and then rather than a version number, we've got something which we've called my app alias, or whatever you want to call it. Now our application is configured to point to the alias, and the alias is configured to forward the traffic to myFunction :1, so the first version. Now if we upload a new version of the code, so we publish version 2, we can then configure the alias to redirect traffic to the function 2. Now we can actually have the alias point to two versions at the same time, so we're doing a blue-green here. We might have, you know, a certain percentage of traffic going to one or the other. That's something that you can configure. So here we've got 80-20 in terms of the traffic distribution. So Lambda aliases are pointers to a specific version of a Lambda function. Using an alias, you can invoke a function without having to know which version of the function is actually being referenced. And aliases are mutable, they are changeable. So here's a view into the console configuration for an alias. We're creating a new alias here called test alias. We can specify a version to point the alias at. We can specify one additional version, so we've got version 2. And then we can specify a weight. So we're saying, let's just send 20% of the traffic to version 2 of the function. And we can change that at any time. Aliases have static ARNs, but can point to any version of the same function. So this is what the full ARN might look like. We've got myFunction :, my app alias. Aliases enable stable configuration of event triggers and destinations. And they're great for your application because you can hard code this into your app and you never need to change the alias in your application code. Aliases can also enable that blue-green deployment type by assigning weights, as we've just seen. Now you must create a version for your alias. You cannot use $latest.